Having Windows 10 startup problems, Windows system crashes, unable to start or frequently restart with different blue screen errors, and sometimes you're showing your PC need to be repaired, or sometimes it's showing different blue screen errors such as critical process died, page fault in non-page area, and frequently prepare for automatic repair and automatic repair results unable to repair our PC. Your PC did not start correctly, or when you click on advanced startup for try to start Windows into safe mode for from troubleshooting steps, also it's unable to start, getting the blue screen error. Here I have some applicable solutions to fix this type of errors. Start with, don't worry, when you get the startup error, startup repair message, click on advanced options. Then click on troubleshoot, advanced options. Now click on command prompt. Here we are going to fix master boot record, which it may be corrupted or didn't allow to start normally. Here type bootrecord.exe/fixmbr and press hit enter key to. Then type bootrecord.exe/fixboot and hit enter key. Then type bootrec/scanos. Now we are going to rebuild the BCD boot record error. For this, type bootrec.exe/rebuild-bcd. And hit enter key to rebuild the boot record. After complete these commands, simply type exit to exit the command prompt. And click on continue. This will be start Windows normally. If still Windows did not start, then you need to boot from my installation menu. Have a Windows 10 installation media, then insert it to your Windows computer or laptop. Or if you don't have any Windows 10 installation media, still good, then visit Windows 10 website and download the Windows Media Creator Center. Showing on screen, click the 64-bit version as per your system version. This is just 17 MB something, so 18 MB. When downloaded, click on Media Creator Center tool. When ask for user account control, click yes. Then select the option create installation media for another PC. Then click next. Here select the language. Normally it's English, United States. Then select the edition, Windows Home Pro, whatever the edition you are having. Then next the architecture. You have options for 32-bit, 64-bit, or for both options. I'm going with 64-bit option. Now click next. Then select what you are going to do. Create a Windows 10 USB flash drive or create a Windows 10 ISO file. I'm going to create a bootable USB drive. So first I need to insert the removable disk to it. It's minimum 4 GB required. Then when you're ready, click next. Here my removable device is selected. Then you click next and the download process will be start. Then it will download around 4 GB data, so it depends on your speeds how much time it will take to download the all data. Wait until complete. Whenever you are ready with your USB drive, then insert it to problematic system. Then press delete key to. This is the BIOS setup. Here on BIOS setup, move to boot tab and change the first boot device, either removable disk or CD-ROM drive. So then press F10 to save the configuration, then press any key to boot from the CD or DVD. This will start the Windows installation screen, first screen. Select your language and the time and currency format. Click next. On next screen, click on repair your computer. Here, click on troubleshoot. You will get the reset this PC option and advanced option. Where in advanced option, you will get various troubleshooting tools to fix startup problems. Click on it. Here, this will represent Windows System Restore, Command Prompt, System Image Recovery, Startup Repair, Startup Settings, where you can access Safe Mode, Disable Driver Signature, etc. So let's start with Startup Repair. Let Windows to fix the startup problems itself only. If the Windows startup repair failed to fix, then click on advanced options. This is the safe mode where Windows start with minimal system requirements and allow you to perform troubleshooting steps. Click on troubleshoot, again in advanced options, click on startup settings, click on restart. Press F4 to safe mode and F5 to safe mode with networking option. Now I am press F4 to start Windows into safe mode. Here Windows started on safe mode and allow us to perform various troubleshooting steps such as fix corrupted system files, check and fix disk related errors, update and fix driver related problems. First we are going to check the corrupted system files using system file checker utility. As discussed before, corrupted or missing system files mostly cause different startup problems such as blue screen errors, stuck at black screen, Windows fails to start, startup repair fails, etc. Running system file checker utility scan and repair the missing system files from a special folder located on Windows system DLLKC. So let's run the SFC utility. To do this, you need to open command prompt as administrator. Click on start menu, type cmd, and from search results, right click on command prompt and select run as administrator. Here now type command sfc/scannow, scan now, sfc scan now, and hit enter key to start the repairing process. This will start the scanning process for missing or corrupted system files. If found any missing or damaged system files, this utility will restore them from a special folder located on Windows System 32 folder. So wait until 100% complete the scanning process. It will take some time, so just I am going to pause this video. Just wait until 100% complete the process. Here, it's around 98% completed. It will take some time, so wait until complete. Don't close this command prompt. When it will complete 100%, it will result if any system corrupted system files found or not. See, 100% completed. Windows System Resource Protection didn't find any integrity violation. That means there is no any corrupted or missing system files on my system. So if this SFC utilities can result system file checker found some corrupted system files but unable to fix them, or Windows Resource Protection found some corrupted files but unable to fix them, that case you need to run the DISM tool, which scan and repair the system image and allow SFC utility to do its job. So that case you can use the DISM command, DISM /online/cleanup-image/restore-health. DSM process, this will start the scanning process. If it will stuck on 30% or 40%, so don't close it, wait until complete the scanning process. After that, close command prompt. Now try to update the device drivers. As discussed before, corrupted or outdated display drivers mostly cause the different startup problems, such as Windows stuck at black screen, showing different blue screen errors. So let's try to update the device on Device Manager. Open Device Manager by click on dvmgmt.msc. Now we are going to disable first startup option. Some users report on Microsoft forums, Reddit, the disable the first startup option help them to fix blue screen errors. You can do these things from control panel. Just open control panel, click on power options. Then click on option change settings that are currently unavailable. Next, uncheck the option turn on fast startup option and click save changes. This will disable the fast startup option. Next, try to repair the disk drive errors. As discussed, startup problems also case due to disk errors such as faulty disk drive, bad sectors on disk drive. But we can run the chkdsk command to check and fix disk drive errors. So let's see how to do. For this, first open command prompt as administered. To do this, click on start menu search. Click on start menu search, type cmd, or right click on command prompt and run as administered. Here type the command chkdsk, the drive letter c, column, slash f, slash r and slash x. The command chkdsk prefer the to check and disk drive for errors. C represent the drive which check for errors and f for fix errors, r to recover the readable information and x to dismount the volume if it's required. So let's click yes, click y and restart the Windows to start the repair process. When you click on restart, on next start, this will be start the scanning process for scanning and repair the disk drive. So it will be take some time. You have to wait until 100% complete the scanning process. Now I just pause this video for few minutes. When complete 100%, I will come. Here it is 100% completed. After that, this will be automatically restart the Windows and start Windows normally. See, my Windows started normally. If after perform all these steps still Windows won't start, unable to start, crashes as startup, don't allow to boot into safe mode, then in that case you can use Understand Data Recovery, which have an option to create a emergency bootable recovery media. Also allow you to recover your lost data caused by blue screen errors, system crash or other bootable problems. Using this software is very simple. Simply create a bootable disk, then you can recover your lost data from a problematic system, crashing system or different blue screen error system. Simply create a bootable USB drive or DVD, then set it to boot from USB drive or the DVD, then recover your data. Just preview and save your data. Let's see how to do this. Simply download it. It's only just 1 MB. So start download. Now install this. The installation process is also very less time, within a second or within a minute. Here it's showing whatever the things you can do with this. So simply start the Windows. Now you can recover here from your photos, music, videos, but we are going to create a bootable drive. So click on create a bootable drive, then click start. Now insert a DVD or you can use a USB drive. I have attached a DVD drive, or you can CD, insert a CD. Click create. This is showing a warning message. This will format the drive. Click yes. Now it's downloading. It will take some few minutes to download some data. Now it's creating the bootable media, which can help you to recover your lost data from a problematic computer. Now everything is ready. This is instruct. Now change your boot order, then insert the DVD or CD or whatever the USB drive you have created, then restart your computer. Now let's Also, you can use this software to on a your recover your data on a normal system, but our priority is recover data from a problematic computer. So let's move to my problematic system. First, insert the cratered bootable DVD to your problematic computer or laptop. Then press restart button. Hit delete key or F12 to access BIOS setup. Here on BIOS setup, move to the boot options or BIOS options. Hit and change the boot option. First boot as a DVD, or if you are using the whatever USB, then you can use removable disk. I'm using a DVD, then select DVD and press F10 to save the changes. Click yes. Now this will restart Windows and it will message showing you press any key to boot from CD or DVD. Here this will represent you the hard disk copy and data recovery builds. So using hard disk copy, you can either copy your entire drive or entire hard disk drive to another backup drive, such as here a external drive. You can copy your whole computer's drive like C, D, E, F, G to select my computer, or you can separately select any drive. For example, I am selecting C drive and click OK. See, the source folder is C drive and the destination is my backup drive, Seagate backup drive. Then click OK. This will be take some time to copy all data from C drive to my external drive, so wait until complete. Here it's completed. You have successfully copy your hard disk. Now see how to recover data. Simply click on data recovery and select what type of data you want to recover. You can either select all file options to recover all files, such as video, music, email, documents, etc., or you can separately select a file, such as you want specifically some music files or some documents, or you are having some important video files. So you can select either single file type, or you can select all file types, then click next. Then select where you want to recover your data, from your whole drive, or you can, if you know the data is on D drive, then you can select either D drive, F drive or G drive. Also, if you don't find your drive, then you can select which disk having your data. See, on my computer I have 3 hard disk drives. If you have idea on which drive your data is there, just select the data and click start. For example, I have selected C drive, then click start. I have some important data on, for example, I have some important data on C drive. See, scanning completed, it's showing a message. If quick scan cannot find your lost data, then please select deep scan, which is a advanced level scan. It will deeply scan your entire drive to find your lost data. Just first check on quick scan. This will be showing that much data I'm having on drive which are recoverable. See the graphic files for images, JPG, PNG files, RAW files, all files are there. Also, if you don't find your data, then you can perform a deep scan, which will be advanced level scan, but it will be take some time for the scanning process. Wait until complete the process. Here, after that, check your data is there or not, whatever the data you want to recover, just find out. For example, I want to recover some video files, graphic images, and some documents. Simply select whatever the things you want to recover, then click on recover. As my computer won't start, so we need to recover data to an external drive. I have already attached a backup drive, external C drive, external drive, or you can insert a USB drive your computer for data recover purpose. Simply insert it to your computer. Here it's my USB drive, it's around 8 GB. Then create a new folder, name it to recover data. Then select recover. This will be take some time to recover your data and copy it to your external drive, so be patient. See, data recover completed, and we have successfully recovered our data. Now you can format your system, or you can reset your computer, whatever things, but your important data will be restored. For your information, this is a paid software. You must have to purchase this software to perform these actions. These are some most applicable solutions and ways to recover your system from startup problems, frequent blue screen errors. I hope I am able to explain you properly. This may be helpful you to recover your system. Still need any help, any query, any suggestion, feel free to discuss in comments below. Also, if you find helpful, then just like this video and subscribe our channel for more videos. If you have any computer problem, ask us in our comments below. Thank you for watching. Thank you.